difficult decision to arrive at who you would consider to be the top athlete in both male and females. But this year's winners were involved in a variety of activities in school, showed strong leadership skills, captained many teams at the schools, It is my pleasure to present the awards to the top female, Lisa Austin, the top male, Jeff Richardson. Now for the Students' Council Award, presented to outstanding boy and girl, and I'm going to let Mrs. Hunt take this over from here.
Student Council has been pretty active this year. We've done a lot of fundraising, and we've just reaped the benefits of that with the installation of the new stereo system, of which we're very, very proud. The all-around boy and girl of the school are those who contribute all of our activities, school activities, academic, as well as athletic events. The outstanding boy and girl this year are Tammy Bell and Jeremy Newton.
At this point, I'm going to call on Mrs. Terdick to come up and introduce our guest speaker.
Graduates, parents, and guests, I'm very pleased to have the opportunity to introduce to you our guest speaker, Mr. Hugh Seaton. Mr. Seaton is already well known to many of us as a neighbor. He tells me he's lived out on Bishopgate for 24 years out in God's country. We've known him as a colleague and as a former principal of Nicolaj Coronation School. In fact, those of you among the graduates who attended Maple Avenue School will remember Mr. Seaton as your grade 2 principal, the one who led the annual parade of ghosts and goblins in Burford. Mr. Seaton shares something with our graduates who are leaving us tonight to go on to bigger and better things. As of July 1st, Mr. Seaton will be joining the ranks of the retired. This is a lifestyle which is becoming very attractive to many of us. Through the years, staff and students have valued Mr. Seaton's guidance, his support, his gentle sense of humor, and his quiet wisdom, some of which he's graciously agreed to share with us this evening.
Trouble with the faces. so before I came to coordination, I did a little research. You people all know research it because you have Mr. Fulford, geography class, and he needs to do lots of research. So number one, I had a look at your certificate, and I had a look at the dictionary. The dictionaries, as you know, are good books, especially if you know how to spell. If you don't know how to spell, it can sometimes be more frustrating than they can be found. But anyway, the dictionary says, or I'm sorry, your certificate says, you haven't seen it, so I'm hung up on it. It says that this is to certify that so-and-so has complied with the requirements for admission to a collegiate institute, high school, or vocational school. I think now we call them secondary schools. I don't think we use the other terms very often. It's secondary school. Now for the dictionary, I looked up the word graduate. It says to finish a course of study at a school, a college, or university, and receive a diploma. I got a kick out of this one, or a piece of paper. One has done so. And graduation, the ceremony of graduation. I'm not finished yet. I looked up one more word, and that was comply. Remember, it said has complied with the requirements, and comply means having done what is required or necessary. So we put all this together, and we discover that tonight we are realizing that we have completed what someone said we must complete. I don't know who that person was, but someone said we must complete certain things in order to graduate from elementary school and enter secondary school. Apparently, you people have complied with the requirements. You've done what is required. Well, you just didn't do this last night. It took most of us at least 9 years to do this. That's quite an accomplishment. Now, a task that takes 9 years is not a simple task. And we received all kinds of awards here tonight, mathematics, English, drama, you name it, the awards were here. Those things are all very important. But I've got to the stage now in education where I can almost say what I want and get away with it. Because after next week, no one's going to be able to do anything, even if they disagree with me. Here's what I think is better than 9 years. And I think these things are very important. And I think that these are the main requirements. Let's see some of the things you've learned. You've learned to think. You've learned to plan. You've learned to act, that means to do. You've learned to listen. You've learned to express thoughts. You've learned to read. You've learned to write. You've learned to calculate. You've learned to share. You've learned to love. You've learned to show respect. You've learned to laugh. You've learned to cry at appropriate times. You've learned to have good times. And yes, you've even learned to handle some bad times. Problem solved and the list goes on and on and on. So 9 years, you've learned to do all these things, as well as these other things that you receive the award for. So putting all this together, you're ready to graduate. You're ready to go to high school. Well, what new things you don't learn in high school? Well, not many. Not too much. I think you've already learned the basics. What you're going to do in high school is build on to what you've learned, like building a house. Put that good strong foundation there. Put up the walls. Get it so you can live in it. Then you start to dress it up. And that's what you're going to do in high school. You're going to dress up your knowledge. So hopefully you will be able to, at the end of high school, do all these things I've talked about better than you can do now. And I think that's the only reason for going on to do it. I'm just about done. In my view, this is the most significant graduation. would be more fuss made over some of those later graduations. But the second, the third, or the fourth, in my opinion, never, ever, ever have the importance of the first. Well, you comply with the requirements. You're going to be given a diploma. After you receive this diploma, you're no longer in grade 8, therefore you don't have to come to school tomorrow. Mr. Cronkite told me he really doesn't care whether you come Monday or not. So again, all I can say is congratulations. You've graduated. There's nothing else to say. Only good luck and Godspeed in all your endeavors.
Thank you. Neil Beckham. Tammy Bell. Shelly Blackmore. Jason Brinson. Jeff Brinson. Tom Casper. Jason Clark. Glenn Clarkson. Matt Clement. Sarah Davis. Kenneth Floyd. Katie Ellis. Thank you. Cheryl Glasser. Jason Gould. Jackie Greasers. Janice Hunt. Mark Jensen. Linda Leach. Amanda Luska. Kara McLeod. Oh, Amy Poole.